Hey guys, we are back for another Rise of the TMNT review from Playmates Toys. We're taking a look at two figures today. I went out and did a little toy hunting trying to track down the remaining three figures, and I only managed to find two. We're still missing Splinter, but I do have the one that I was looking forward to the most outside of Meat Sweats. So we've got Baron Draxon, so this is the new big bad in the show, and then we've also got the Origami Ninja. I actually was able to get two of these because, you know, it's not a unique character. You gotta have at least two, right? So we've got them in that standard packaging. You can see them there in the window. We've got some turtles on the backer card, and then the back for each figure has the green color scheme along with a bio and, you know, shots of the figure along with the full lineup. So let's pull these guys out and take a look. All right, guys, here we go. We've got our figures out of the package. Like I said, I've got two Origami Ninjas, and we've got Baron Draxon here. And I figured we would do these together just because, you know, they're both villains in the show as far as figures go. But based on what I understand so far, they aren't actually associated. So Baron Draxon goes with Meat Sweats. He is, you know, Baron Draxon is the big bad. Meat Sweats is under him. Baron Draxon is trying to mutate everyone into mutants. The Origami Ninjas are created by the Foot Clan, which is not associated with Draxon. At least that's how I understand it so far. Like I said, I'm not 100% in the know on everything about this show just yet, so I'm still kind of playing it by ear as I figure stuff out. So we're going to talk about them individually. We're going to talk about the Origami Ninjas first, and then we're going to take a look at Baron Draxon. All right, now here is our ninja, and we're only going to focus on one for time being because we don't need to talk about two at the same time. So we've got a pretty standard ninja figure. The only real kind of odd thing about his design in terms of his general look and feel is the head, which is basically a big hooded design, and really the only paint on this figure is in the head. We've got the kind of orange-red Foot Clan logo on the face. That's what that is. So you've got the toes and then the actual foot. That's the red. And then we've got those green eyes inside. I actually like that. I think the general look and design of this character, of this type of character, works really well. I do think it suffers a bit when it's translated into toy form. All things considered, I think there is a little bit of just sloppiness going on with this figure, and it's not just this one, it's both of them. Some of the joints are kind of rough. The hip pegs on both figures want to pop right out when I'm trying to move them around. And these guys suffer from what I call the classic vintage TMNT sculpting problem. These guys are sculpted with a weird foot that is angled. So you've either got to have him reared back on his heel, or he's got to be standing on one toe. And these guys also suffer from what has happened with April in this line, that they have really spindly small legs and they just want to flop around. Once you get him, they'll kind of stay. So you've just got to kind of find that sweet spot and keep them there. But I got to tell you, at least from my experience so far, it's been really frustrating to keep these guys standing up. They're just odd. I mean, this kind of foot, I really hate it. I don't like this kind of thing on toys. And there is nothing down here at the ankle, so you can't do anything about this either. It's just unnecessary. You know, I get that it adds a bit of a quirk to their design, but at the end of the day, if I can't make him stand up in about 30 seconds, something is definitely wrong with the design. Now, as far as articulation goes on this guy, it's pretty standard for this line. Nothing too crazy. You've got a head that's on a ball. It'll swivel, but there's no real up or down or anything like that. Arms go out all around. We have got a single jointed elbow, and then we've got rotation there, and there is rotation at the wrist at the end of the pajamas. And then we've got it's not really a waist twist, it's more of a diaphragm swivel. And then the legs can go out there on hinges, but they're forward facing, so they kick forward. If you swivel them, they'll go side to side a little. And then of course they do rotate in there as well. But there is nothing else from the hip down. It's all in the hips on this figure. So that's a problem. I think really the design is fine. I think they look cool. They're definitely somewhat unique. I really like what they did with the Foot Clan logo on the face. For some reason, that didn't stand out to me at first. I was like, okay, they've just got some red on their face. And then it dawned on me, okay, that's what that is. So that makes a lot of sense. I do think they look cool, but I think that they suffer a little bit when it comes to actually posing them because of this design. Now, as far as accessories on these guys, we do have two different kinds of weapons, and so I've got both figures out again. So this guy has got a small kind of double-bladed mini sickle almost. It's this guy right here, which is just cast in black plastic, standard stuff for Ninja Turtle weapons. I think this is pretty sweet. I like this. But the other accessory that they have is actually really interesting and pretty clever, all things considered. Since these are the Origami Ninjas, they have like origami paper throwing stars. They come with three of them. They're all slightly different in size. So there's a big one, a medium one. So there's the big one in his right hand, your left on the screen, the medium one, and then the small one. This guy can hold the little sickle thing really, really well. The throwing stars take a little work to get into their hands, but once you kind of shove them in there, they hold just fine. I think the weapons that they have are really nice, and those throwing stars, the origami paper throwing stars, are very clever and really play up the whole origami ninja thing for these guys. And of course, next up, we have got Baron Draxum. And this is a figure that I'm pretty interested in. It was one of the main draws for me in this first wave, just because I think he looks like a cool villain. He's an interesting character so far. And yeah, it translated pretty well to figure form, although he definitely does have some weird quirks in the articulation department, even for this line. So let's just get that out of the way. So the head does not move at all. There is zero articulation here. As far as I can tell, it is glued onto that neck. These little guys right here, little mutant buddies that he has on his shoulders, they aren't articulated per se, but they are affixed to him. They kind of act as like shoulder pads, but they do move. But technically, it's not a point of articulation. They peg into his neck, and then they just sort of sit there. The arms can go out. They can swivel all the way around, but of course, you're going to hit these little dudes up here. Single joint at the elbow, and then there is rotation there. But he doesn't have anything at the wrist. There is nothing there. He doesn't have anything at the diaphragm. He doesn't have anything at the waist. So he is all one solid buck in the center. Legs can kick forward and they cut at the thigh so you can rotate there. And then he has weird knees because he's, you know, a mutant guy of some kind. I still don't know a lot about the guy, but he has these odd backwards knees almost, so he can hinge backwards, but they don't really do a great deal. So you can kick forward, but that's really goofy. And honestly, it really doesn't make any difference because his cape basically keeps him standing straight up no matter what you do, because it just ever so slightly hits the ground. So even though he has these weird knees, he stands up perfectly fine. I have yet to really see him fall over too much, which is pretty fantastic because, you know, I've had a couple issues with that in this line with the ninjas and April specifically. Where I think this figure shines is in the looks department, and there's not tons and tons going on here, really. A lot of molded plastics, some paints. I just like the design of this guy. I think he's interesting. He's very different compared to the other figures in the line, for sure. You know, you can tell that the origami ninjas really don't have anything to do with him, and he just sort of stands apart from all the other figures. So we've got this nice metallic gold paint on the head and on these face horns, whatever you want to call them, and then on the you know, kind of girdle region of his waist down here. And we've got different tones of kind of greenish blue colors. We've got the red hair. We've got these little guys here, which I think are pretty cool. They're obviously different. You know, they look kind of devilish and demonic almost in some ways. And then we do have a soft rubbery cape and the kind of loincloth that runs down here. So he just looks cool. I don't really have too many issues in terms of paint on this guy outside of this foot. It's kind of sloppy, but otherwise it's nothing major, nothing I'm not too concerned about any of it, really. I just think he looks pretty imposing. He looks very much menacing while also maybe not necessarily being as evil as he seems. You know, I don't know yet. Time will obviously tell. But we do have a couple other accessories to talk about with this guy. He does come with a few, and they're all kind of based on the fact that he wants to turn everything into mutants, or at least that's what it seems like. So, you know, we've already talked about these little guys that are on his shoulders, but he comes with ones that are kind of freestanding. So we've got this little guy here, and then we've got this little guy here. So they're just some sort of, you know, little mutant creatures that he's got. This one sort of looks like it resembles this one in a sense, but they look a little different as well. And then this one kind of looks like this one, but he's got different colored eyes. These are red eyes, and this one's blue. So I like these, you know, I like these little mutant buddies that kind of come with a lot of older Ninja Turtles, and it's kind of cool to see that they're doing some of that here as well. He also has these other things, these Ooze Skeetos is what they're called on the backer card. I've not seen these in the show that I can recall yet, you know, but I again, have not watched much of it. And they're little mosquitoes that I guess they drain mutant ability. You can put them on his wrist, and I guess you can put them on other figures as well. You know, have them kind of sitting on him so he can, you know, launch them towards an enemy, or have them on one of the turtles or something being sapped dry. So I kind of like the idea behind these. They're all just solid color plastic except for the eyes on these little dudes. But I think they're cool. They're fun. They kind of play up his interest in turning everything into mutants and making everything kind of under his domain as far as all of mutant kind goes. So yeah. He's pretty limited in terms of articulation, but I think he looks cool as far as sculpt and paint, and then I like all the little guys he comes with. So overall, I'm pretty happy with these two sets of figures. I do think that the Origami Ninjas are very cool looking. I like their spread of accessories. Ultimately, they are kind of wonky in the sculpt and articulation department. That is definitely a frustrating pain point for me, but overall, I can get by it. It's just worth noting, and your mileage may vary on how hard it is for you to get these guys to balance. Baron Draxum, I think, is a big draw for this entire line. He's very different, very unique. He is, again, very limited when it comes to articulation. You're mostly just going to have him standing there looking imposing with all his little dudes around him, but he's a cool design. He's got some good paint apps. He's got some nice gold metallic paint, which I'm always a fan of, and he just looks cool, and he looks like a fun figure, and that's ultimately where the enjoyment for this line for me comes from. So that's going to do it for this look at the Playmates Toys Rise of the TMNT Origami Ninja and Baron Draxum figures. Let me know what you guys think. Feel free to like, comment, subscribe, and share, and until next time.